Welcome to This Ready to Craft. In this video, I will show you how to create foam board bat wings. To begin, I will mark the center of my sheet of foam board. Then, I will sketch out my wing shape. I recommend looking at reference images while you sketch. Don't be discouraged if your drawing doesn't come out perfect the first time. As you can see, I had to go over areas a few times before I was happy with how it looked. Cut along the center line. I'm putting a new blade in my hobby knife. This will make my cuts not only cleaner, but easier to make. You want to cut out this half of the wings in one piece. This is because we are going to use the part we remove as a template for the other side. Be careful when removing the background, as the thin parts of the wings can be delicate. Once it's removed, flip to the other side and trace. Once you have this side cut out, trace your wings onto another sheet of foam board to create two copies of your wings. Here, I have my second wings cut out, but they don't match perfectly. I'll tape the two sets together and then trim parts here and there so they are more uniform. Make a quick mark on the sides where your two pieces meet. After putting another new blade in my hobby knife, I'm going to bevel the edges of my foam board that will be facing out. I hold my blade at an angle and run it along the edge of my board, only cutting the foam and bottom paper facer. I was a little careless here and cut into my foam board. I will just use a bit of tape to keep that in place. Another way you can bevel is by cutting from the top. I personally find this way is a little more difficult to control how much I am removing, but I recommend trying both methods to see what suits you. Once my edges are beveled, I'll give them a quick sanding. I use spray paint for this project, which has to be done outside. If you use spray paint that is not water-based, you will first need to use a styrofoam primer. I will add a link to our test Tuesday that shows how spray paint affects foam board in this video's description. Time for our fabric. I'm going to be using a shower curtain that I found a good deal on. Notice that I made a little cut towards the edge. I'm just testing how badly the material will fray when it is cut. I'm going to cut a piece and set aside the rest of the fabric. Since I'm going to paint my fabric, I'll first tape it down. This will make it much easier to work with. you'll use acrylic paints to create a gradient effect. Once I'm happy with my paint, I'll peel the fabric off my board and hang it up to dry. When the fabric has dried completely, we can start attaching it to our painted wing base. Apply white glue generously to the back of the wings. I'm going to use a few staples to keep the fabric in place while the glue dries. For more delicate areas, I will use straight pins to hold things in place. I let most of the glue dry before continuing. Remove the staples and pins. I'm making another test cut to make sure that my acrylic paint will prevent my fabric from fraying, which it does. Now I'm going to cut away the excess fabric. After a little while, I noticed that holding my blade almost parallel to the foam made it much easier to cut. From the point, I will extend the cut straight down. Here, I'll make the cuts between the fingers of my wings. your glue ready to attach the other piece of foam board. The board developed a slight curve after I painted it, so I'm going to weigh down the middle and then pin the other parts of the wings together. I allowed this to dry overnight just to be certain that the glue was set. Unpin and set your wings free. I can see some bits of fabric on my edges, so I'll add a little black acrylic paint here and there to cover it up. I'm going to use elastic for my straps. I'll attach the elastic first with hot glue, then with a few staples. With that end attached, I will hold the wings against my back and test how long I need my straps to be and cut there. Cut a second piece of elastic to match the first. Attach the other ends of the elastic the same way. Check which direction the hair lays on your faux fur to decide where you want to cut your piece from. I'll trace around my wings and get an idea of the shape I want to cut out. You may want to use scissors, but don't. Use a utility knife or a hobby knife, and I will show you why in a moment. I'm pulling the fabric up off the table a little, since I only need to cut the back fabric part. You can see that there's a little bit of fluff from us cutting with the blade. When I cut with the scissors, I am also cutting through some of the fur, which makes an even bigger, fluffier mess. I will use hot glue to attach my fur to my wings. If you plan to wear these wings in a way that your skin will touch the back, you may want to cut a second piece of fur to cover where the elastic is attached. There you have it, spooky bat wings. If you try this craft out, we'd love to see it. Our social media links can be found in the description. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If there's a foam board craft that you'd like to see a ready-to-craft of, let us know in the comments.